Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform drag and drop in Protractor. And to do this, I have an application which is AngularJS application where I have a small button here, AngularJS drag me, and you can just drag and drop like this. So after drag and drop, the color is turned into green. So we'll see how we can automate this scenario. And basically it is a drag and drop action in Protractor. Now go to your Visual Studio Code and I'm creating a new test under test cases and I will name it as drag and drop dot js. And now first I'll create a describe part. So I'll say describe. Inside the describe, I'll say name of the description. I'll say my suit comma function. And this function need to implement inside this it block. I'll say it, and here I'll give the test name called drag and drop, and then I'll say function, and inside this function we need to implement the code as a function, and now here we need to write. So this is basically AngularJS application, so we can directly launch my browser without doing any settings. So browser.get, and this is the URL of application I'm going to launch. So after launching my application, I'll just maximize this page by using browser.manage.window.maximize. So this particular command will maximize your window. Now after that, from this application, we need to know what is source element and target element. To perform the drag and drop, source and target element we need to know. So here this is basically a button. Let me just inspect this element. And once you inspected this element, there are certain attributes available here. Basically, it is an AngularJS element, so you can find ng model. So ng model is list one. So I can make use of this locator and attribute as a locator. And the destination is this one. So if I just inspect this drag below button, so here list two ng model is a list two. Now I'm going to use these two elements, which is a source element. This is the target element. So first we need to capture those two elements. So for that, what I can do is I'll say element dot. So this is element of by dot model. So this is the locator which is we have in Protractor. So by dot model, and the ng model attribute value of the first element is list one, I guess. Here it is. Inspect this element once again, and you can see ng model is list one. So capture this list one and then specify here. So this is the first element. All right, so this element we need to save in a variable. I'll say var. This is my source underscore element. Similarly, we need to capture the target element. Now inspect this target element, and the ng model attribute value is, I'll say this is, I think, list two. Let's capture this. So we need to capture the second element. And for this element, we need to capture list two. NG model is a list two. Now again, element of by dot model, and specify this model. And then this is one attribute. So we need to save this in one more variable. Let's say var. This is my target element. I'll say target underscore element. So now we have a source element and then we have a target element. Now we need to perform the drag and drop. So source element, we need to move into target element. So there's a drag and drop. So for that, we have a method called browser.actions. Actions dot, there is a direct method is available, that is drag and drop. I'll say drag and drop. And here we have to pass two arguments. One is source element, whichever element you want to drag, we need to say pass that element. And the second one is a second element. This is a target element, source element and target element. And source element will be moved to the target element and then perform. So this particular statement will perform the drag and drop operation. So after performing drag and drop, I'll just wait for some time here to see the operation. Let's say browser.sleep. And I'll put 5000 milliseconds. So this is how we need to perform the drag and drop. So we need to just use browser.actions.drag and drop, source element and target element, dot perform. So this is my program. Now let us run this code. And to run this code, we need to add this JS file in the conf.js. Now go to conf.js, and here we need to specify the spec name. So spec name is drag and drop. I think this is uppercase letter, drag and drop.js. And once you configure this spec name, now go to the terminal, open the new terminal. Now we need to execute protractor space and conf folder inside this conf.js. Now once you execute this command, it will launch my page, then it will perform the drag and drop operation. Now let's execute. So now it is launched in my browser. Then it is maximizing the page, and also it opens the URL, then maximizing the page. Yes, now it is perform the drag and drop. So this element is turned into green. Fine, so then after that page is closed, one spec is executed, there is no failures. So this is how we can perform the drag and drop operation in protractor. So the method is browser.actions.dragandrop. We need to pass the source element and target element.perform. So this particular statement will perform drag and drop. Okay, so that's how we need to perform the drag and drop. And that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.